The Minecraft Blog proudly presents Decorating with Heather. Today's episode, Bathrooms.
Hey guys, welcome to Decorating with Heather. I'm Heather from the Minecraft Blog, and today we'll be building a luxury bathroom. These are the kinds of bathrooms you would find in a master bathroom of an upscale house. So let's begin by looking at the room that we'll be building. You can use basically whatever materials you want, but for mine, I chose a cool color scheme. In case you don't know, that means more of like a wintry color scheme, so there's a lot of grays and blues and definitely a lot of white, as you can tell. But the thing about the materials is you have to make sure that it matches, because you don't want half of your room made out of birch wood and half the other half out of acacia wood. That's not going to look good, and it's going to clash. So just whatever you do, make sure that your materials match. So let's take a look at the room. You've got the counter and the sink, and cabinets on the left side and drawers on the right side. And in this decorating tutorial, I'll just show you how to make both of those, because they're relatively easy. You have the toilet and a toilet paper holder, and I'll also show you how to make that. You have the shower that you can actually walk in, and it's pretty cool. And you have the bathtub that you can put water in if you wish. It's relatively simple to make if you know what you're doing, and I can show you how to do that. So now I'll show you how to build all of this from scratch. Right now I'm using Nate's resource pack. It's my favorite resource pack because I think it looks a lot better than the default texture pack, but it doesn't differ too far from them. When building, I like to work from one side of the room to the other, and I also like to build the biggest thing first. So in this room, I'm going to be building the shower first, or show you how to build the shower first. So these are the materials that you're going to be using. So I'll just let you guys look at that. So this room is about 7 wide and 11 long. So if you're trying to model this bathroom, that's that's how big it is. The shower I built is 4 long and 3 wide. I'm going to start with that, because that outlines it. And then I'm going to take my white stained glass panes and fill that in. And what I like about these panes is that it provides like a foggy texture. And I'm going to put a side to put all of, you know, soaps and stuff on, as well as on the top and bottom, because if this was real, you would want something to catch all of that water off that end. You wouldn't want it going all over the floor. And then I'm going to put a hopper in the ground. This looks close to a drain. It also matches, so that's why I'm going to use it. And then you're going to take a tripwire hook. You're going to take a tripwire hook and put it at the front so it looks like a shower head. So you have the basic outline for your shower. Next, we're going to do the counters. It's about 5 long, and make sure you have room to put your sink there. For this bathroom and the color scheme, I'm going to use a hopper again. I like it because it attaches to the wall so it looks like a real sink. And I'm going to put a tripwire hook on top of it because it looks like a faucet. And then I'm going to show you how to do the cabinets and the drawers. Let me just grab that. Okay, so for the cabinets, you're going to want the handles at the top. So you're going to do a lowercase o, two spaces, a line, two spaces, and a lowercase o. On the second line, you'll just do a vertical line. Same on the third, same on the fourth. All right, we'll do that again. Lowercase o, two spaces, vertical line, two spaces, and an o. A line on the second line, line on the third line, line on the fourth line. So there you have your cabinets. For the drawers, you can either put this line at the top or the bottom, but I prefer it at the top. You're going to do lines all the way across, lowercase o, lines all the way across the third line, and a lowercase o. All right, we'll do that again. Lines all the way across the top, lowercase o, lines all the way across the third line, lowercase o. And so there you have your cabinets and your drawers. But personally, I think the drawers look better. For at least for this bathroom anyway. Okay, now I'm going to show you how to make the toilet. You do this by taking two stairs, have them, you're going to have them stacked on top of each other. Like that. Okay, there we go. Like that. And then you're going to take a hopper and attach that, to the bottom stair. Once again, I like this because it looks like actual plumbing. And then you're going to put a trap door on top of that. So you have your basic toilet. And then if you want to go further, to make the flush lever, you put a item frame on the side, and then you put a lever in the item frame. And you can put it however you want, but I think it looks best like that. Okay, and now we're going to make the toilet paper holder. And for this, you're going to need a button, a piece of wool, and a item frame. So you're going to want to put the button on the wall first, and then the item frame, and then a piece of wool in the item frame. And you have your basic toilet paper roll. I think looks so cool. That's one of my favorite things. Okay, so you have the left side of the room practically done. So now the last thing that we have to do is the bathtub. And mine was about 6 long and 2 wide. Make sure you do the same thing to the top. And I'm just going to go ahead and fill in this side. I don't want it open, but you guys can feel free to leave it open. And then if you want to make it look really fancy, you can put stairs on the side so it has a nice arch to it. And don't forget, step up there. You're going to put a drain in and a nozzle. So you have your basic bathtub. Now, if you want to go on and decorate it more, or if you want to stop here, you know, go ahead and exit out. But I would consider watching it more because we're going to learn how to... I'm going to show you how you can spruce up your builds even more. So we're going to do this first off by putting bath mats in, which can be a typical carpet. You can do whatever color you want. Just make sure it sticks to your color scheme. But for me, I don't really like corners, so I always want to put something in the corner. So to make this look even more decorative. I'm going to put a column in the corner. Columns usually make things look more fancy. And then I'm going to put a painting on the wall. No. Okay, so a 4x4 picture is probably the best thing that you could get in that spot. But, yeah, so you're going to put really any picture you want, but I think the 4x4 looks best because it fits, like, that amount. You can use ladders as towel hangers. You can really get as fancy as you want with this. You can even go as far as putting shampoo bottles in your shower. Something that I really like to do is put flowers in bathrooms, or flowers really anywhere. The orchid is my favorite flower, so I usually put that in, like, everything I decorate. If you really want to, you can also put water in your bathtub. Just make sure you make it even so it looks nice. And I guarantee with this design, you'll have the bathroom that everyone would want to use. With that, you have learned to build a luxury bathroom. So thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time on Decorating with Heather. And for more videos like this, as well as other Minecraft videos, subscribe to the channel. Thanks, guys! Thanks for watching, guys! For more decorating tips and other cool videos, click on the cute little jack-o'-lantern to subscribe, or visit us on the MinecraftBlog.com. Bye!